I'm Dave Lefkowitz. With me in the studio,
I'm Jeff Goodman.
Well, you didn't do the and.
I know.
Usually do the and.
I'm Jeff Goodman.
There you go. And we're here from now until 11 o'clock to talk and goof around, and then from 11...
just to lubricate you and get you all ready for Dave's Gone By.
Well, so we can slide the next show into you
easily.
Very delicately and easily.
Painlessly.
I love it. Yeah, well, I don't know about painlessly if you've ever heard our show.
But Dave, tell them what we're going to be discussing today and on Dave's Gone By.
It's going to be actually a pretty cool show. I call it my pre-birth...
Go get something.
Okay. Jeff is running off to the car because he forgot his notes. Well, running would not perhaps be the operative term if you ever saw Jeff move across a room, but whatever it is, he'll be back in about 2 minutes, which gives me time to talk not about the big time, but about Dave's Gone By, which is the big program, the show that I've been doing here since October of 2002 on this very radio station, WGBB. It's an hour of talk radio, comedy, music, interview, sketches, all sorts of stuff that's different every time, and hopefully fun each and every time. And tonight should be no different. It's going to be a very talky episode, for the most part, of Dave's Gone By at 11. First of all, it's my
Dave's birthday time!
Oh, my God. Oh,
no, hold on.
Oh, my God. Jeff actually brought a cake.
Wait, hold on.
Oh, he's
pretend, because yeah. A couple of the candles...
Yeah.
Like, didn't light, although they looked
for. They're not exploding candles, are they? I know you want this time slot for yourself, Jeff. But, oh, wait. No, here we go.
Okay.
Oh, this is so sweet. It's like...
Wait, ready?
Yeah.
Happy birthday to you. Oh. Happy birthday to you. Oh. Happy birthday, dear Dave. Dave's Gone By, big time Dave, whatever he wants to call. David. Happy birthday to you. Woo!
Oh, thank you. Oh, and the studio audience is just sitting here thrilled.
How old are you now?
43.
You look like a cow.
Wait.
Now blow up your candles and make a wish somehow.
Okay, it's blowing and wishing time, which no, I'm not going to go there. Okay, and by the way, it's this lovely cake with sort of toasted almonds. Yeah, and there's even a baby cannoli right on the top where it says Happy
B-Day.
B-Day.
And you know who wrote that? I did.
What, you took your own icing and stuff, or what did you do?
I needed it. Uh-huh. So when I went to the supermarket, I saw the icing was there, so I opened the cake and I wrote on it.
That is sweet. Thank you, man. It's really a nice looking cake. I hate to do it. Ooh, wait, the candles are sparking.
Just blow
what the hell's wrong with that?
Okay. I don't know.
Whoa, they're shooting off sparks. What the hell?
Oh,
this is going to be fake candles. I'm blowing now. Yeah, oops, I got them all but one, which means, oh my, they're all lighting up again. What's going on? Two of them blew out. Hold on. Whoa.
Hey, blow it out.
I guess I blew it. Dude, what candle sparks like this? What the hell is wrong with these things? Hold on. Be right there, folks. All right, this is a joke, right? These are joke candles?
No!
What do you know? What do you know? They keep relighting. You're going to set off fire alarms in here. Open
blow
the... Open
out the last two candles. Blow out your candles.
Here we go.
Thank God.
Those are well and truly blown out. They're blown... See, there are two candles on the cake that keep re... How do they do that?
I don't know.
Actually, can you do me one quick? Can you open that window quickly before alarms start going off in here? But it's a really sweet cake. I'm looking forward to this. It's like a nice cannoli cake. It's really, Do you want to give a shout-out to the place you bought it, or did you actually have to pay for it?
I baked it myself, Dave.
No, you didn't bake the cannoli
no.
cake.
No, did you blow out the
candles? I can't blow out
them! Blow out! They're just candles!
You want to... No, I don't want to... I have so much saliva on this cake now, I'm the only one who'll ever want to eat this. Maybe if I hold it near the microphone.
I didn't spit it. Say spit it. Blow.
Maybe if I blow towards
it. Pucker your lips and blow.
You know how to do that, don't you? A gentle one from the side.
See, thank God.
All right, yeah, okay. I mean, this is more of a visual joke, you understand. And Jeff is waiting for that other one to go on. He's disappointed now that only one is lit.
No, you can blow them out. See, it's simple.
All right, Jeff just blew... Ha, 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 ha!
What? It blows out!
And then it comes back up again. kind of like my sex life. But, you know, ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to the Birthday Big Time, to be followed by the Birthday Dave's Gone By at 11. Greetings from Long Island, where every highway is a sunrise. It's time for Dave's Gone By, an hour of comedy, talk, and music brought to you by Total Theater, with your host, Dave Lefkowitz. You've never heard anything like it, so sit back, relax, squeal if you must. Here's the host of Dave's Gone By, Dave!
Tropical hot dog night! I shoot flamingos in a fruit fight! Every color of day, twirl it around at night.
Well, there goes the neighborhood. Welcome, everybody, to the 204th episode of Dave's Gone By, the birthday show, ladies and gentlemen. I call it the winter of 43 because I'm turning 43 in 2 days, and I'm very happy to celebrate on the air with you at WGBB. Very happy to celebrate also with my good guest co-host, Mr. Jeff Goodman. Hey, Jeff, how you doing?
Fine.
Jeff is already like he's looking at me with like these being a little angry, offended. Actually,
I don't know what to do.
No, it's totally cool. Just be you. I told Jeff that I because I'm doing a special like birthday show tonight.
And where's Joyce? Joyce was supposed to be here tonight.
No, she'll be calling in, or we will be calling her.
How are we going to shove cake over the phone to her?
Well, it's modern technology. It's 2007. We can fax it. I can take the cake and do like a PDF file of it, and then send it to our new computer at home. And amazingly enough, she can look at it, a mush there. Finally, my computer died this week.
The Commodore 64 laptop?
I'm going to miss Pong. No, it's not, thank God, it's not completely dead. I can still get files and stuff off it, but it's been dying for a long time, and then I deleted some files accidentally, and now it's running in a ridiculous kind of safe mode way. And I'm just pulling files from one computer onto this other one that I've been delaying putting together and finally have.
And what kind of computer dost thou get?
It's a very nice Dell. I mean, I like Dell, and we got another Dell. And it was actually a gift of a very, very nice person who I was kind of working with for a while. A fellow named Marty, whom I was kind of working with for a bit.
So Marty
kind of likes you? Huh? Sorry?
Marty kind of likes you?
No.
He gets you computers?
He got me a computer, yes, and I was very, very grateful because it's a very, very nice computer. Thank you,
wow.
Marty. Yeah.
Marty, my birthday's coming up soon.
Well, he's a good guy. And
how do I get to know Marty?
You want me to introduce him to Marty? I'll introduce him to Marty.
Marty, will you buy me a computer?
He didn't buy me a computer.
You said he bought you a computer?
He gave me. Okay, it's a little different.
The water thing
people
just
have
burped.
Yeah. Everything's burping. I was farting in the restaurant. The water thing is burping in the Dave's Gone By guest room.
In the Dave's Gone By studio.
Studio. That's thank you.
It's like Bob Barker's studio in Hollywood.
Okay, go ahead, Jeff.
No.
Go ahead.
I just realized that I was going to say it's next week, but it's not. It's a week from from Monday.
Right. January 29th.
A week from Monday. I'll be on The Price is Right.
11 a.m. CBS. And Jeff has gone through this story. Maybe not on Dave's Gone By, but certainly
so we're not
going to
talk about it until next week. Next week will
next
be the
week
big,
we will
because
mention.
Next week you won't forget it, trust me.
Certainly will not. But instead, well, that's a week away or so. Let's talk about what's going to be on Dave's Gone By.
Let's talk about what happened tonight.
Tonight is going to be my birthday show, so
what
about
do we get
me, ladies and gentlemen, mostly. It's going to be, first of all...
Just like my birthday show was about me.
Your birthday show was not about you because you didn't even show up.
Well, that's because I was tired.
Yeah. You what? You were tired, I know.
I was tired. I forgot what I
I'm
did.
Tired
I was like
too.
Exhausted. No, I was truly exhausted, I believe.
Yeah. No, that's cool. But I have to show up for my birthday show here or else they're going to be hearing Chinese music.
Well, would you have had a party for me? Did you have a cake for me that I missed?
Yes! I had a cake, female and male strippers. I had, what do we have here at the station? Fireworks.
Really?
It was amazing.
Presents galore?
We had tennis. We actually took the roof off of the building and put down a slate thing where people could play tennis with that. And
we called it pond.
I tried to get the pond, but they couldn't. It was too cold already. It was
pong.
Oh, pong. I missed that. See, sorry.
Commodore 64.
Okay. Let me tell people while we still have a few minutes here.
Okay, what's going on?
What's going on the show? First of all, because it's my day, or will be on Tuesday, I'm going to remember three amazing, wonderful moments, days, sort of, in my life.
Was one the day you met me?
No, these are amazing and wonderful. We're tragic things. No, I'm kidding. They're kind of nice memories that I'd like to talk about at some length, but not all show long, because I want to leave time for also Inside Broadway with some Broadway news and a review of the off-Broadway show A Jew Grows in Brooklyn, which I was attracted to by the title, certainly, because I was a Jew who grew up in Brooklyn. Jeff, where did you grow up? Queens?
I grew up in Merrick.
Oh, were you born in Long
Island? In GBB land.
Really, yeah.
GBB's studio was in Merrick at that time, and it was big. And I remember listening to GBB on my AM radio next to my bed.
Oh my gosh.
I was like, and listening to the newest song by the Beatles.
Wow. That was when we were a real station.
It was like a top 40 station before there was top 40.
Mm-hmm. But were you physically born in America also?
No, I was born in Syracuse, New York.
Mm. So when did your family move to?
We moved to Long Island. America was filled in with landfill. I think it was 62,
and Long Island 63. Was filled in with landfill. Oh.
We lived in Freeport for a year while the house was being built.
Uh-huh.
And then we moved into Merrick when all those South Merrick houses were being built.
Nice.
All of them that were being sold for about $5,000 to $10,000, which are now like $500,000.
Please. I've got friends. I was talking with they want to buy a townhouse at this point, and townhouses they're looking hopefully to break under the $500,000 ceiling for, you know. Townhouse is like a connected thing, isn't it? Or
yes.
Okay.
Thanks. It can be. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's like a co-op, or is it a house? I'm still not.
No. Townhouses are connected.
Yeah. So, I mean, I'm figuring jeepers, creepers, but where they're hopefully when they
move.
They
call the townhouses where they're very, very thin, and it's like one big building and it's like sliced.
Yeah. Well, they want to consolidate. They want a smaller place. So.
Right.
Anywho, let's see. Inside Broadway plus my memories plus memories of some other people. In the pre-show, we said rather quickly goodbye to actor Ron Carey, who died. Comedian actor Ron Carey, who was on Barney Miller and a bunch of the Mel Brooks movies. Well, a couple of other people died this past week, including Denny Doherty of The Mamas and the Papas, and Curt Dempster, who was the artistic director of Ensemble Studio Theater. So I'm going to give them a little bit of a send-off later in the show. So let's begin the program, which we always do with advertisements. But before we do the advertisements, let's tell the people who's advertising on the show.
Well, and they're all giving special discounts for your birthday, aren't they?
Yeah, the usual 10%.
I think you should bump it up another 30%.
Yeah, I think so too. I can't do that.
Well, you go in and you tell them that Jeff told you to ask for the special Dave's Gone By, Dave's Birthday, 43%.
And you know what? They may give you 11% if you do that. I think Hewlett Minuteman Press.
I thought they would give you 43% off.
No, they won't. Believe me, they won't.
Because you're 43 years old.
Yeah. No, they won't even give me 43.
Well, I can understand that.
Okay. Anywho, let me do these things.
Well, you asked me to talk, and now it's like, I'm just going into the corner and crying.
Oh, boo-hoo. Boo-hoo. No, go into the corner and tell us about fancy schmancy balloons.
Oh, yeah. Fancy schmancy balloons. You have a party, call us.
And how do we call you?
Oh, at 516-797-3229.
516-797, what was that? 3229?
Yeah, well, I'm kind of depressed.
But it's not just balloons, it's what? It's
your party decorating needs.
Right. Also,
we have that on tape. I'm tired of saying that.
Okay, we're going to do an ad for that. And we do have an ad that you'll be hearing later on for MortgagesRock.com.
Oh, I love them. Because you don't just get a mortgage there. You can learn to sell mortgages there.
Beautiful. And did we talk about Performing Arts Insider, the theater
magazine?
No, we
didn't.
Performing Arts Insider, the theater magazine.
It's my Bible of Broadway.
Now, that one you can get 11% off this week if you subscribe.
I think you should give them 43% off for a 5-year subscription.
Let's see, I don't even have, there is no such thing as a 5-year subscription.
Well, there will be this week, and it's 40% off. 43%
off. I'll have to think of, let's see, a subscription price that's plus 43% with the usual price.
No, I'll be plus 42%.
Oh, okay, that's fair. I think that's reasonable. What's also reasonable is let's get to some advertisements so we can come back with Inside Broadway.
Yay!
And Dave's Gone By, the birthday show.
Happy birthday to Dave.
You rock! Yeah, yeah, you rock! You know what else rocks? Mortgages rock! Yeah, because MortgagesRock.com gives you the chance to help your friends get the loans they need. College loans, home improvement, new trailer. MortgagesRock.com helps you help them. And the more work you do, the more commission you get. Full service, fully licensed, MortgagesRock.com has real experts on the phone, at the website, in the office, making you a bigger, better broker. MortgagesRock.com, where making money never sounded so good. Rock on, mortgages! You don't have to pay big bucks on Broadway to enjoy a funny play. You could sit in the comfort of your living room, or bedroom, and read a whole book of hilarious comedies by the one and only me, Dave Lefkowitz, Marriage, Babies, and the End of the World, filled with my unique humor, satire, and spoofery. If you like my show, you'll love my book, $20 hardcover, $12 soft. Buy it at davesgoneby.org, Marriage, Babies, and the End of the World. That says it all, doesn't it?
But listen to me every hour.
Inside Broadway, brought to you by Total Theater's Performing Arts Insider, your everything theater guide. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, Inside Broadway. And I'm here. I'm Dave Lefkowitz with Jeff Goodman on Dave's Gone By. Got a couple of news items about Broadway, and then I'm going to review A Jew Grows in Brooklyn, which is playing at the 37 Arts Theater down, well, actually up, way west on 37th Street. That's why they call it that. Anyway, here's what's happening on Broadway this week. The announcement of a play that's definitely going to be coming to Broadway in the spring season is going to be at the Imperial Theater opening May 2nd, called Coram Boy. Have you heard about this, Jeff?
I was the one who told you, and you said, what's coming in? I said, I don't know, some play.
Well, that's the, I figured out what the play was. It's called Coram Boy. It's
Coram
an adaptation
Boy.
Of a novel by Jamila Gavin, or Gavin. Helen Edmondson is the actual author of the play, and it's the story of two illegitimate children, a slave child, and a rich man's abandoned heir. I think it takes place in the 1700s.
And it used to be called The Prince of the Pauper.
No, I think it's a little darker. I think it's kind of a grueling, sort of heavy, deep play, but supposedly quite good. So Coram Boy coming in May, just opening before, I guess, the Tony cutoff.
To an Imperial Theater near you.
Now, here's a Jeff kind of question. What's at the Imperial now?
Nothing.
What was at the Imperial most recently?
I told you.
I don't remember.
It was that musical about the record shop that I can't remember.
High Fidelity.
Right.
So you told me, like you told everybody who's listening.
Oh, you asked me like it was...
Yeah. Well, no, you like to do that. That's your thing of guessing what was at what theater.
I don't know. What was there before that?
What was there before High Fidelity?
You tell me.
I don't know. I don't follow the...
Dirty Rotten Strangers.
Dirty Rotten Strangers?
Scoundrels.
Dirty Rotten Strangers. I like that title, too, the sequel. Anyway, moving on to more Broadway
What was
news.
There before Dirty Rotten Scoundrels?
Okay, what?
Les Mis.
And now Les Mis is back, but in a different way. Where's Les Mis playing now?
The Broadhurst.
Okay, there we go. Enough. Now, here's... Okay, what's playing currently at the L'Enfantin?
Just for a limited time only, Beauty and the Beast.
And what do you mean by that?
It's closing! Yay!
Yay? You don't like Beauty and the Beast?
Oh, it's run its course for me.
Okay. I mean, I like
I mean, after Donny Osmond plays Gaston, what else can you do?
Well, hey, they've got Tony Danza playing Max Bialy stuff.
Oh, my
what
God.
What else can you do there?
I can't, you know, I've been calling to try and get press seats for that. I'm dying to see that.
I'm not.
Because, I think it's going to be a train wreck.
Well, why do you want to watch a train wreck?
Why doesn't everyone else want to watch a train wreck?
But anyway, let's tell people about... This was, I think, pretty surprising news.
It was very surprising.
Beauty and the Beast. I mean, it was not hurting financially, even though it's been running since April 18th, 1994.
But I told you my theory about this.
What's your theory?
My theory is that Disney's closing it so they can open The Little Mermaid.
That's not a theory. That's what's happening.
Yeah, no. But my theory is that if Little Mermaid opened... then it would hurt Beauty and the Beast because it's geared to the same audience. So rather than do that, they're just going to open up a new one, a new musical, and there'll be more demand, and they don't have to see Beauty and the Beast go downhill.
I don't think I would say that, except they'd be fighting Mary Poppins anyway.
No, because
Mary Poppins is that audience.
Yeah,
totally.
I guess. Yeah.
So I think it's just not enough theaters. If Disney had a smaller theater they could move Beauty and the Beast into, I'll bet you they would have moved it. And if there's a surge of Beauty and the Beast, maybe they'll even move Little Mermaid if a big theater opens up. We'll see. I mean, it's still Beauty and the Beast isn't set to
close
until
Tarzan.
I'm sorry.
They can close Tarzan.
I think they might. I'll bet. Maybe that's what will happen. I'm not going to bet money on it, but if Tarzan
I wouldn't bet money on that.
Oh, you think Tarzan's going to last for?
Yeah, Tarzan's going to make it last. They don't want to have a flop. Their biggest flop was Aida.
No, Aida wasn't. I think Aida made its money back. That wasn't a flop.
Yeah, but that's
that was the closest thing they had to a flop. I gotcha. Anyway, Beauty and the Beast is going to play until the end of July. That's around the time that Little Mermaid is going to be trying out in Denver. And when Beauty and the Beast ends, it will have played 46 previews by 5,464 regular performances. And by the way, Mermaid does come with some serious credentials. It's going to have music from the movie by Alan Menken and Harry Ashman, and the book by Doug Wright, the fellow who created I Am My Own Wife. So,
wow,
should be, even for adults, something to see. And no, Julie Taymor is not involved. So
maybe it's just going to be one person doing all the different characters.
She's Ariel. She's the king. She's the Octolady.
And it's all going to be done in a heavy German accent.
Oh, and you know, we mentioned Art Buchwald a moment ago because we're doing a goodbye.
Oh, guess what, Dave?
What?
He's still dead.
Still very dead. Extremely. And any music that he was working on? Decomposing. But did you know that Art Buchwald was a playwright, and he had a Broadway play in 1970 at the Helen Hayes Theater? Do you know what that play was called?
No.
I only know this because I remember seeing the cover but never really looking inside and loving the title. Sheep on the Runway.
Really?
Yeah, you ever see that? It's not a terribly interesting cover. There's no sheep on it. It's just like this rectangle. But Art Buchwald wrote a play called Sheep on the Runway that ran about 100 performances. I don't know. But it starred Barnard Hughes and a couple of other...
But was it the Helen Hayes or the old Helen Hayes?
There was another Helen Hayes?
Yes.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Helen Hayes.
They tore down the Helen Hayes in the Marasco Theater and they built the Marriott. Don't you remember that?
No, you are into the theaters. I'm into the plays that are in them.
I'm into the plays, too, but I like the building.
Yeah, okay.
But don't you remember, there was a third one they tore down, too.
And that would have been not the Eurus. What was it? The
Eurus. What did they say? Eurus is like seven
blocks away. I had doctors working on my Eurus last week. No, what was the other? Quickly, we've got a...
Oh, I'm trying to remember. They had... that was where Mummenschanz played.
Oh.
That's what the theater was famous for.
I give the phone number for people to call in, but there's nobody listening who would know the answer to this question at the moment.
Well, the number if you want to call in is
631-888-8811. 888-811. Actually, if you want to call in and wish me a happy birthday, we can take a minute or 2 hours.
Oh, yeah, David will take a minute out of his busy day to take a compliment.
A birthday wish. A happy 43 to me. Come on, it's my show.
I have a birthday wish.
What's your birthday wish?
I should shut up.
Thank you.
Sorry.
Whoops, there goes your microphone. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back with more of Inside Broadway after this. The best Broadway magazine just got better. More listings, more contact numbers, more inside information in Performing Arts Insider. And not just Broadway, off-Broadway, off-off, dance, cabaret, opera. As one dramaturg put it, Performing Arts Insider is a gold mine of information for the theater professional. 21 times a year at your doorstep, the whole world of theater, with 10% off for Dave's Gone By listeners. Visit PerformingArtsInsider.com or call 516-295-1511. 516-295-1511. Performing Arts Insider. It's Broadway the best way. Broadway the best way indeed, Performing Arts Insider, which sponsors Inside Broadway. And now, going to talk about a show that's playing at the 37 Arts Theater off-Broadway. It's apparently in an open run, and I don't know, it's kind of, I hate to call the area a Jewish ghetto, at least theatrically, but the same building has both A Jew Grows in Brooklyn, and 25 Questions for a Jewish Mother playing at the same time. So maybe this is going to be like the old Jewish rep or American Jewish theater where it's not going to be specifically Jewish, but that's apparently where the Jewish plays are going to go. And it's kind of neat, except you do have to sort of schlep way west, almost like 11th Avenue and 37th Street, to get to the 37 Arts Theater, which is a block further west than the Zipper Theater. Anyway, what A Jew Grows in Brooklyn is a one-man show with a band, and it's Jake Ehrenreich, this personable middle-aged guy, telling about his life. Of course, Jeff is shouting from across the room as he drew a Bourdain? What else could he be? And the whole thing is about his being Jewish and his Jewish family and his life, and it's kind of interesting, and he's not that interesting, and he's kind of laid back and a bit lame, and because he has what should be an extremely interesting story to tell about his family. He calls his family survivors of the Shoah. They got out of Eastern Europe at pretty much, well, not quite the right time, but you know, and then, of course, there are horror stories, and his parents were in Poland, actually, towards the very end of 1939, and got out. So I assumed, and then they were in a camp. However, they were not in a concentration camp. They were in a Russian labor camp, which, horrible as that is, and probably as horrible almost as a German, not a death camp, but a labor camp, probably 20 degrees colder. So, what happens? I still don't feel that that should be called part of the Shoah, if they got out in time to avoid the Holocaust, even though both parents between them had 10 brothers and sisters, none of whom survived that era. So, okay, there's a story there, and a story of how they got from Poland to Russia, and how they got from Russia to America. Does Jake Ehrenreich tell this story? No. He just says, they got on the boat to Ellis Island, they made it, they came. So most of the show is either him tumbling or singing sort of Jewish songs or American pop songs written by Jews, or telling about his life and doing the typical sort of, oh, remember this about Brooklyn and this about the Passover and this about the Seder, and it's all kind of,
What's the average age of the audience, like 100?
more like 60 to 100. And they're kind of liking it, but even them, even this built-in enclave ethnic audience, when the jokes don't land, the jokes don't, and you're rooting for him because he seems like a nice guy, and he's like every bar mitzvah entertainer you've ever seen.
I hear he goes north of super sex.
You heard that joke. He told that joke. How did you heard about it? You didn't see the play. How did you know that he told that joke?
It's an old Catskills joke.
Yeah, but of all jokes, he tells that one.
He goes, I'm here to offer you super...
Tell the joke properly.
Okay.
Do it.
I was a waiter in the Catskills,
mm-hmm.
and I came up to a woman. She goes, I want to offer you super sex. And she goes, I'll take the soup.
See, he tells it, it's like an 85-year-old man. So he's like, Superman, I'll take the soup. It's a little cuter with an 85.
Why would he offer 85-year-old men super sex?
Super sex, get it?
Right.
Huh? Well, that's the joke.
No, he has to go to a woman and say, I'd like to offer you some super sex.
But in his joke, I think it was a hooker who comes, whatever it was. The joke sort of landed. He does land one really, really good one, actually. He says,
well, that's the one good joke he lands. Ruin the whole show for everybody.
Well, this will keep people from having to see the show. I remember very, very vaguely my bris, because it did not go well. As I recall, I didn't walk for a year. I thought that was... I never heard that before. I thought it was amusing.
Okay.
Well, that's one of the better jokes.
Did that happen at your birth, David?
I don't remember. So.
Well, you probably didn't work for a year.
Apparently, since this is my birthday show, I will say that I was told by my parents that I went from crawling to running, and I never walked. I just literally crawl, and then one day running across the room with my diaper falling.
You know why? Because you were healed.
The chain on my neck kept me from running too far.
His parents had the first invisible fence, kept giving him shots around his collar.
That explains a lot.
Are your parents calling in today?
No, but they're welcome to. Dad, if you're listening in, give us a call, 631-888.
I'm trying to talk to your parents today. 631-888-8811. Mr. Please call in.
Because Dad usually listens, so he's probably going to give us a call to talk to him. Huh?
Can we call him?
Yeah, if there's time at the end, but let me get through
The
end of this very lukewarm. No, it's cool. This lukewarm review.
I thought it was finished, the show.
The show isn't finished. It will be soon. No. It got meh reviews, and you can see, like, the audience wants
to
like
this,
it.
Where is this theater?
Were you not paying attention?
I was.
37 Arts. It's on 37th Street, all the way around 11th Avenue.
It's not where the Hudson Guild was, is it? In the
Hudson
apartment?
Was on 26th.
Oh, that's right. 20 that's
something
right.
Street.
I was thinking
this
that
is a relatively new
theater. That would be a good place to have it, though, because you have all the Jews living there, and then they don't have to go so far.
The Jews found it. They if they want to find it, they'll find it.
If you want to meet some Hadassah ladies.
And this is the one of those shows that kind of tests the thing that if you have an ethnic target audience, they will sit through anything. And it's kind of true, but then again, they're sitting there, they want to be entertained, and to an extent it is. I mean, he does Romania, and he does a whole bit about the Catskills that is fairly lively, but even there, he does this whole long extended piece where he's playing like one of those Catskill tumblers, one of those guys who has to, in the morning, he's making jokes by the pool. In the afternoon, he's serving food. In the evening, he's got to be the MC. Then he goes into the band and plays the drums. Then he plays the drum, you know, he's got to do everything. And so, Jake Ehrenreich feels he has to do everything within the context. And you're not sure if he's supposed to be good, or half good, or almost bad, because he's still sort of him, being him while doing this. So there's a whole thing, it's just not, there is an amateur hour-ness to it.
Mm-hmm.
But, hey, you know, there are worse ways to spend an hour and 45 minutes.
And how much money?
Not much worse. I don't know how much it costs, but I give it about 2.5 stars and can't really recommend it. Sorry, Jake.
But Dave, I want you to go to another show. I have a show for you, another one-person show, but I think it'll be better. It plays on Saturday nights, right, like, next door to the stage door of Carnegie Hall.
What's that?
It's called Sinatra Remembering the Sands.
Sinatra Remembered or Remembering?
Remembering the Sands, I think. It's called Sinatra.
You saw this one?
I'm seeing it this week. I'm very excited about it.
How can you recommend it? But yeah.
No, I just said I want you to see it because I'm seeing it. Oh. And it sounds really good. It's like this Sinatra impersonator who had done the other Sinatra show recently.
Uh-huh.
And it's just about him and his stories of Vegas, which I think is going to be very interesting.
Okay. I mean, they keep coming up with these Dino, Frank, and Sammy reviews and mm-hmm. Sinatra reviews.
This
they're
is
all one okay,
person show. It just plays on Saturday nights.
All right. It sounds fairly interesting. You know, I like Sinatra, so I will check it out.
You don't like him?
No, I said I like Sinatra.
Oh, okay.
I'm not.
Well, we're going to have to kill you for a second.
Well, you're a big Sinatra fan, right?
No.
So?
If you don't like him, he kills you.
Even Frank, he comes from the grave, and he smacks you like he did Ava Gardner.
He what?
He smacks you around like he did Ava Gardner. Ava, come here.
Smacked around Ava Gardner?
Supposedly. What, you hadn't heard that?
No.
Yeah, it was a tough cookie. Finally, I crumbled.
I heard something very funny, speaking of smacking around women.
Yes. How far afield we've gone from Inside Broadway, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah.
Well, it's sort of Inside Broadway.
What?
Well, I was talking about someone about being, they were talking about being a has-been because you don't want to be a Gabor sister, is what they said. I don't know. I was watching like Entertainment Tonight. He said, you don't want to be a Gabor sister. And they go, I don't even know what that means. He goes, well, at one point, the Gabor sisters were like a really big deal.
Well,
and they became lesser and lesser, and now there's like a nothing deal.
Yeah, the last time you heard about her, she was in like a traffic incident.
She slapped the cop.
Oh, right. Oh, that's where you're talking about.
That's the slapping thing.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. It just came in.
Well, you know, I wouldn't mind being with their money and with their still celebrity and the residuals. I wouldn't mind being a Gabor.
Darling, you are a Gabor.
A Gabor brother. Maybe not a sister.
That's what we should dress up for Halloween.
Maybe you.
I'll be Shasha. You can be Ava with the wig.
I'll be Eddie Albert. I'll be Arnold Zippel. Anyway, we got to go further in Dave's Gone By.
Sorry.
This, we've been Inside Broadway, thanks to Performing Arts Insider Theater Magazine. Tune in pretty much every week now for an Inside Broadway segment with news and reviews of the theater And we will be right back with more of the birthday show of Dave's Gone By. We've just been inside Broadway, thanks to TotalTheater.com and Performing Arts Insider.
Listen to me.
That's right, buddy. Listen to me anytime you want, because Dave's Gone By episodes are preserved on compact disc. Entire shows with a nice cover, track listings, own your favorite shows, or give a Dave's Gone By CD gift. Dave'sGoneBy.org has an episode guide, and you can order there, too. $11 for CDs, shipping included. Add $1 for autographs. Go to Dave'sGoneBy.org, buy a CD, and listen to me.
Welcome to Self-Indulgent Radio. Happy birthday, Dave. It's Dave's Gone By, and it's Dave's birthday.
Am I not allowed to be self-indulgent on my birthday?
Absolutely.
Thank you, thank you.
There's nothing wrong with being self-indulgent.
Oh, okay.
But you just have to admit to it.
Okay, I'm being self-indulgent.
Yay!
It's my birthday, hooray!
Yay!
And I'm going to indulge myself even further by bringing... Yes.
I think this is going to bring joy to the audience, actually.
Joy.
This is not self-indulgent. This is you're sharing something. So you're being selfless and sharing the caller on the phone. Is that what you're talking about?
That is correct.
Yeah, well,
ladies and gentlemen, on the phone is the woman I have yoked my life to and egged me on, well, however we want to put that, my darling and beloved and very, very smart and professional and accomplished doctor wife, Dr. Weil. Joyce, are you there?
Yes, honey.
I guess he doesn't know about us, Joyce, does he?
Well, Jeff, you know, I think we do know how the fire started on you know, in our local town. Did you purchase the cake and deliver it to us?
Joyce was listening to the pre-show.
Yeah.
I'm having a big cake I'm bringing home for you.
But can I just tell
it's
you...
very lemony. Yeah.
Yeah, I heard it was very lemony. When you do that yay part, you sound kind of like... a mixture of Elmo and that boy that wears a helmet on the Crank Anchor show. It's not a good yay.
Wait, what yay?
Yay, like that.
When do I do that?
You guys are doing it the whole show.
Yay, like that?
Don't do that.
Well, you know, big time.
I don't do that, you know. Dave does it.
No, Jeff, don't do it.
I didn't do it. Dave does it. Dave's the retarded.
No, let me try it. Yay! That sounds like that doesn't sound like special.
You sound like the Wiggles on helium or something. It's not pleasant.
Yay! How's that?
No. Remove that.
And there was much rejoicing. Yay.
Rejoicing, get it?
Oh, very good. A little Monty Python reference and a wife reference. So, Joyce, by the way, happy, happy, even though this is my show and my day.
And by the way, Joyce, aren't you thrilled to be married to a man with a birthday this week?
Well, you know, Jeff, it's what I live for. It's the sole reason why I wake up in the morning.
You just gotta have one. But no, you are a doctor now. It's basically official.
Well, I will say until the first of February, then I'm relieved. But it's pretty good. You know,
Joyce,
pretty...
my neck hurts when I do that.
So yeah, honey,
I'm not that kind of doctor.
What kind of doctor are you?
I'm a doctor of the philosophy, not of medicine.
So philosophize.
So essentially she's basically useless. No,
philosophize,
kidding,
Joyce.
David?
Yes?
Do you want me to wish you a happy birthday?
Only in a philosophical way, though.
Okay, think it and decontextualize it for us.
Oh, Lord.
Decontextualize? Is that a word?
I think you two spend way too much time together. This is my feeling.
Well.
You need to both go in the naughty corner separately.
Thank you.
We are in the naughty corner. It's called WGBB.
Thank you, Super Nanny.
Jeff got the reference. Jeff, when are you going to be on Price is Right?
Oh, honey, please.
Dave, who's been wishing himself a happy birthday for like the last 3 hours, is now... I've said one thing about The Price is Right, and all of a sudden now this is way too... I'm impinging on his time. I'll tell you next week, because it's actually a week from Monday. I don't want to take up Dave's birthday.
A week from Monday at 11 o'clock in the morning on CBS. There. And Jeff wins some stuff.
You mean it's not on David's birthday?
No.
No, it's not.
It's on January 29th.
That is correct.
It's almost a week after Dave's birthday.
Which is on January 23rd. Tuesday, if you want to send me a gift, people. Or drop me an email at davesgoneby@aol.com. Wish me a happy.
Or davesgoneby.org.
Dave, you... Oh, Dave. Oh, my goodness.
You're right.
I need you, Dave. Jeff, you have raised the bar. I didn't think I would get him a cake. Now I have to get him a cake.
I'll send the cake back to us. Here, you just light it up on Tuesday.
Oh, I don't know.
Tell about some of the lovely, delicious cakes that you have gotten for me over the years for my birthday.
I basically go to Carvel.
Ooh, that's nice.
And I asked him...
Did you get him a cookie puss?
He had a cookie or puss dressed as a rabbi. We had that done 1 year.
It was Cookie Pussowitz. We purposely asked the guy to draw, like, Payas on
it. Yeah, he fixed it up. Was very cute with a yarmulke. And then 1 year he had a... You know, David loves...
Did you get a Fudgy the Whalewitz?
No.
Fudgy Whalestein.
Uncle Whalestein.
I went to school with him, actually.
We got you a Carvel cake with a picture of a potato on it.
You know how I love
that
cake?
Nice.
That was
because
they do those photo things on the tops of
cake. Yeah, the photo picture thing.
That was neat.
You didn't, like, put a potato on the cake?
No.
No, get messy.
David won't eat vegetables. Not too close, Jeff.
Yeah. Unless Joyce has a stroke, in which case, you know, I'll... I don't even know what that means. Yes.
I hope that, you know, you can shack up with Jeff, because if you're bad, you ain't coming here.
No. It's cold out.
You're not coming to my house.
Yeah.
Listen, I spent all day, God bless your aunt, at Costco.
Yes.
The living room is filled.
Which aunt?
Well, let's tell everybody just how much great stuff is in our living room.
It's food.
Home Invaders, if you're listening.
Oh, yes. Hungry Home Invaders.
It's just food. It's...
Did you hear about the guy who won? He had a great quote. The guy who won Survivor this year.
What?
And he asked, "What was the first thing he did when he got home?" He goes, "I got a Costco membership, and I bought lots of food." And he goes, "I bought so much food that it wouldn't all fit in my refrigerator, so I had to eat it then and there."
Did you hear about that guy who won like this amazing, like huge lottery of $100-something million?
Yeah.
And now he's it was like $300 million that he won.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And lost. Yeah. And now he's broke and he, like, can't pay lawyer's fees and stuff like
this
that.
This is always the story.
It's always the story.
That's the story of Curtis, the first millionaire, one of the first millionaires in New York.
He won $1 million or $2 million and spent it, lost it, whatever. How do you lose $300 million?
You get a bad, you know, bad broker,
bad
accountant.
Yeah, you get scammed, basically.
I don't care. How do you not put away, $3 million for a rainy day under the mattress, for God's sakes, in the coffee can, you know?
He won $300 million?
He And then we lost it all.
Well, first the first 150, by the way, goes right to the government. So,
all right, well,
David, your aunt also gave you a scratch-off ticket. Maybe you might have won $1 million.
Yeah, right. We'll
you
see.
You don't know. You didn't scratch it off. It might be the big winner.
The big winner?
I've been scratching my nutsack for years. No, I've never won anything, so.
This is a scratch-off lottery. You might not, you know, who knows?
You got to be in it to win it.
We could actually afford health insurance, honey.
Oh, so it's a couple of mil.
So tell us about it. So how is Dave at home?
David at home is the opposite, Jeff. As I said to many people when I'm out with him in public, as you can imagine, say, how do you deal with him? And really, he's quite quiet at home. David needs an audience. So for me, he's, you know, in the room typing. He's quiet. He wants to be alone. He wants to just eat, go out, have a few meals. That's it.
And you're not a good enough audience for him?
No, he's low-key. If we're outside and he's among people, he becomes crazy, David.
Yep.
He starts dancing, singing. You know,
farting. Don't forget the farting in restaurants.
Yes, but everybody in the neighborhood knows him, and they're all, you know.
Do they like him, or do they run?
Charming. When we go to the one diner, they, oh, Dave, how are you? And they call me Mrs. Dave. That's my title. And then everybody knows him.
They're going to have to say Dr. Mrs. Dave.
Well, they know what he eats. They know his order.
What does he eat?
Hmm?
Well, what do I eat?
Basically, any meat product
you can get your hands on,
any carbohydrate that you can,
really?
Yeah, I like, when we go out, basically for lunch, it's always a bacon burger. Because I don't want anything else. Nothing else seems really worth it. I don't want a salad. I don't want a tuna melt or mish.
Does he ever eat skirt steaks?
Oh, he does.
Oh, totally, yeah.
Yes, but yes, he does.
I like the Romanian tenderloin. That's a skirt steak.
In the kosher place, he likes that.
Yeah.
Oh. Does he like pot pies?
No, not
Thank
really.
God, no. We went to Ireland, and we had to eat them for a couple weeks, and it was just atrocious.
Yeah.
I never want to see a pot pie as long as I live.
I mean, the pot just wasn't strong enough. If it had been Jamaican, then maybe.
Darn that, Mrs. Swanson.
I could have got you 17 pot pies for $1.50 today.
God.
I could have got you a cake there. Those cakes, the sheet cakes from, like, Costco, they're like $20. They feed 40 people. And,
yeah, we
and
have it
delicious.
For a year.
Why don't you just get him a regular size? Well, Costco has nothing regular
size. Right, exactly,
size.
Yeah. For...
But, Jeff, the thing is, I didn't plan on a cake, but now I feel the pressure. Because you did such a nice presentation and all I have now. How can I top that?
That's, well, the cake is crappy tasting, so yeah,
but
it's pretty easy to top.
Yeah, but, David, he surprised you. He brought it in. He had to spend for matches.
Yeah.
He put candles in.
Can you imagine? Maybe buy a whole box of matches. I'll send some matches home for you.
Please don't.
Just send them in the mail. Put your address on with white powder in it.
Oh, my God. No, but that was lovely, Jeff. I think that was great.
I appreciate that.
It's okay, because he did so much for me on my birthday.
Well, you weren't there. You were AWOL.
I did get you. Didn't I give you something at some point, like a card or something? I got you a little DVD.
That
was Christmas? Well, I got you something for your birthday, didn't I?
No.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
But that's okay.
Good, okay.
You gave me the gift of... Dave ship.
No, just give him the cake back. Take off Dave.
I gave you my virginity.
Give him the cake back.
I didn't want that. You can have that back too, David.
Oh, I wish I could. If I had a needle and thread to sew myself back up. But anyway, I don't
I thought you, David, still were one, no?
Well, you would know, dear. But anywho.
Now, where's your father? Your father should be calling in.
Well, I guess that's...
Or your mother.
I think I said Dad doesn't like to be... He likes to prepare. He doesn't want to just go off the cuff.
But I want to talk to Miss Daddy Dave.
Well, we've got 15 minutes left. So, Dad, if you're listening, or anybody, if
I'm just trying
number
to ask
one
some questions.
Pam.
Pam didn't call. That's right.
Yeah, she didn't call on New Year's.
Pam's working. Listen, that girl's working.
She's checking out those
girl.
Books.
I've seen her. I've 50 bucks, and you.
She's checking out those books. She's also very religious.
She's number 4 prostitute in East Rockaway.
No, she's a beautiful woman, both inside and out. She's
That's
a lovely
right.
person, sweet person, nice to everybody at the library, even when they harass her. I don't know how she does it.
I don't know why Dave says you're such a nasty person, Joyce. You're so nice.
Thank you very much.
When you're sleeping in the garage with the cricket.
Yeah, oh, the crickets are quiet in the winter.
Good.
In the summer, as soon as the weather gets warm, there's like 4,000 crickets in our garage.
That's because they're dead in the winter.
I'm assuming they're eating all the
spiders.
Did
you read the story about the lucky duck? Maybe you could do that today.
You know, Jeff, I hate to say, you know, although David will not like this, you were correct. I heard it was a freezer as well.
Yay!
And the reason that the duck didn't die is because they had the setting too low.
Oh.
Like, it was very low. They didn't have it cold enough. It was probably in a garage or somewhere, maybe in a trailer. And basically, it wasn't cold. It was cold, but not, you know, like a freezer should be.
Yeah, it's like didn't freeze that duck.
Yeah, a lot of restaurants just don't know the proper temperature to serve cold duck.
Well, David, she opened up the door, and she saw the little duck staring at her.
Aww.
I mean, that's sad.
But she did bring it to a vet, which I think is pretty incredible.
Well, thank God.
Yeah, what was she going to do, wring its neck? Her husband is a hunter. She just, like,
but that duck is really one lucky duck. I'm telling you, I love that story.
Yeah.
Well, they said that he was saved twice. One because the guy was such a bad shot, and second because the freezer was so bad.
Wouldn't that be hilarious if they let it go in a sanctuary and 2 seconds later was eaten by an alligator?
Oh my God! You killed Ducky! You bastards!
Well, they have that. Everything I watch on the Nature Channel is some animal attacking and eating and killing another.
Yeah,
oh, you know, the Steve Irwin special.
I think they call that Baghdad. What?
The Steve Irwin special is on his last thing.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
but they destroy the stingray tapes. Who cares? Nobody wants to watch anything, but I want to see that point go through.
No, but you know what it was? It was about the 10 deadliest sea life creatures.
Oh.
And the stingray was not one of them.
Now it is.
Yeah. Well, there's supposed to be these gentle little, you know, what is it called? UFOs of the sea, because they're in that weird shape.
Yes.
And then, yeah, I don't know, he just got unlucky.
He would have lived, except he pulled out the barb. When you pull it backward, the barbs are released into your heart. If he would have left it there, it would have been fine. And then they would have went to the hospital and surgically removed it.
What? Well, he didn't, and that's why he's not.
I know. Well, there was an older man, I think 70s or 80s, the same thing happened, but he didn't remove it. He went to the hospital. You know, they removed it there. He was fine.
Well, look at that guy. I mean, there's a guy they showed on MSNBC's Countdown who has this wonderful relationship with a lion that he raised from a cub. So he goes up to, have you seen this, Jeff?
That was a woman. That was a woman who
went. A woman.
Oh, it was a woman. Excuse me, a woman. Goes up to the cage, hugging the lion.
I have it too. The disease that when you can't remember anything is that
aphasia. Yeah. No, but she's licking her and she's hugging her. Now that's wonderful. It's adorable. She does it every day. There's going to be one day when the lion's not in the mood.
You said like a Siegfried and Roy, right?
Yeah. And then she'll be Siegfried and lunch. She'll just be lion chow.
She'll just feed them the birthday cake.
But anyway. I want to move on with the rest of the show, but I want to thank Joyce. Actually, Joyce, do you want to hang with for the rest of the show?
Yeah.
Or do you need to scoot?
Why don't you call your father-in-law and see what's up?
Oh, I'm not going to call him. I don't want to call them late. They'll be scared. They'll think it's something bad.
Yeah. Don't call a Jew after 10 o'clock.
No,
that means
David's parents are not like, if you call them and it's late, they will be scared.
If it's between 10 and midnight, it's an accident. After midnight, it's death.
If we make him pick up the phone now, we'll just say bad things.
Yeah. And he will be angry, and that will not be nice.
You know what happened to Dave? He was born! Yay!
Well, not with that yay thing.
Anyway.
That'll set anybody off.
So, Joyce, just hang with us for the end of the show, okay, if you can?
Quick to commercial, Dave?
Put you on a hold. Yes, I got to, and I do want to get on with a couple of other things on this episode, this birthday episode of Dave's Gone
yes,
By.
Yes, we know it's your birthday, Dave.
Don't go away. D is for Dave, F is for fun, S is for silly and special, X is for excellent entertainment, DFSX, Internet Radio, playing vintage episodes of Dave's Gone By, Saturday nights at 11. It's part of Live 365, but all you gotta do is visit davesgoneby.org. Click the link and listen online to classic Dave's Gone By, Saturdays at 11. DFSX, letters that stand for terrific! Minute Man, the superheroes of photocopying, printing and binding. Minute Man, no job too big or small. Minute Man, family run since 1975. Minute Man, 1315 Broadway in Hewlett, Long Island, next to the new Lowman's shoe store. Tell them Dave sent you for 10% off. Minuteman, hero of our photocopying dreams.
Do you want to dance under the moonlight?
voice there that you heard was... Who do you think it was, Jeff?
The guy from the Mamas and the Papas?
Well, yes, but which guy?
The dead one?
Yes, exactly. No, but most people, I think, thought throughout the history of the Mamas and the Papas that John Phillips, who wrote or co-wrote nearly all the songs that they did, was also the lead singer of the band. But he wasn't. It was Denny Doherty who had that sweet, high voice. And Denny Doherty died. Denny Doherty died. He's dead. He's Denny. He's dead.
And you know what?
What?
Art Buckwell's still dead, too.
He's with Denny. I mean, you know what they're eating? Denny. Yeah. But no. Let's do a nice little remembrance for him. Denny Doherty, one quarter of the 1960s folk rock group, the Mamas and the Papas, died just 2 days ago on Friday. He was only 66. He had had kidney failure.
Chicken sandwich?
No.
Ham sandwich,
and that's not what killed Mama Cass. Mama Cass died, I think it was a massive heart attack.
She wouldn't that be
wait, Jeff.
Wouldn't that be a great movie?
What?
What killed Mama Cass? What really killed Mama Cass?
A short movie, but a good one. They already went through that. It was such a lie and such a thing about the ham sandwich. And Dennis already didn't die of a ham sandwich either. Just maybe too many ham sandwiches killed. What kills kidneys? Why do you... I mean, livers is alcohol.
Oh, the protein.
Pee.
Or that woman who drank too much water and didn't pee, that was probably kidney failure, too.
Yeah.
So he was on dialysis for the last month of his life, and then it just didn't pull through. Died at his home in Mississauga, Canada. He was born in Halifax.
So he moved far away.
Well, I mean, he toured the world. He was in the Mamas and the Papas.
He ended up in Mississauga from Halifax.
Well, I guess you go all the way around the world to wind up back home, especially when you're ill. So anyway, Doherty was... His first band was something called, where was it?
Papas and the Mamas.
No, it was the Colonials, which then became the folk outfit called the Halifax Three. And then he hung out and got to know John Phillips and Michelle Phillips. And then they brought in Cass, and as everybody knows, the song
Creek. Right?
Who did?
Didn't this guy marry Mama Cass?
No. If you ever saw any documentaries about the group, Mama Cass really was kind of into him and liked him, but then he... You know, Mama Cass was not the most attractive woman in the world, despite her magnificent personality and extraordinary voice. She had, you know, some extraordinary poundage that made her, you know, Mama Ass. So anyway, I don't know what that means.
So nice to people, all the dead people on your birthday. Happy birthday, Dave.
Well, you know what's kind of sad and weird is that of the four members of the Mamas and the Papas, only one is left.
Who?
Michelle Phillips. And it's weird that more members of, like, the Rolling Stones, the Grateful Dead, Aerosmith, even
the Beatles.
Yeah, but, I mean, I'm talking about bands that lived such a drug-addled, insane existence, have somehow lived longer than most of the members of the Mamas and the Papas.
Probably the cast of Hair.
Yeah, exactly. I don't even know what that means. But, so, of course, we know about the Mamas and the Papas. Their songs included Creek Alley, I Saw Her Again Last Night, Go Where You Wanna Go. They also did some lovely cover versions of, like, I Call Your Name, dedicated to the one I love. And Doherty made a solo album in 1974, which I've never heard, but I'd be kind of curious about. And he was the voice, apparently. He played both the Harbor Master and all the characters' voices on a TV series called Theodore Tugboat.
That was on before Scooby-Doo.
Maybe it was just on in Canada. I do not remember that one at all. You know, another creepy thing is that Doherty is survived by three children, and his three sisters and a brother, and he had two wives who died before he did. So I don't know if he was marrying, like, these much older women, or if there was something in the Doherty house that's
maybe
a little
he
freaky.
Was killing them, David.
I don't know. But anyway... Don't want to say anything too bad, because he's a great voice. It was a wonderful group.
Denny Doherty's dead.
Denny Doherty's dead. Did you see his off-Broadway show?
Denny's already alive?
He did in 2003. He did a show called Dream a Little Dream, the Mamas and the Papas musical, where he went through his life. And
I didn't see that.
Yeah. I think
chance of seeing it now.
Well, no. I didn't see it either, but I remember when it came out, I was like, well, basically, it's just him being able to get up there in front of people every night and say, way back when she was still hot, I bagged Michelle Phillips. I mean, that'd be enough for him. He wasn't doing it for the money.
He did Michelle Phillips.
Yeah, what happened was she was obviously married to John, but John was so into drugs and everything that he was an absentee everything. And eventually she drifted into an affair with Denny.
So, how about Mama Cass?
I guess she sort of watched from the bathroom while she was stuffing her face. But before we finish this Dave Says Bye segment, also want to say goodbye to Curt Dempster, who was the founding artistic director of Ensemble Studio Theater, and he was found dead at his home in New York City on Friday. He died the same day. He was 71 years old, undetermined cause of death. He found the EST in 1971, and apparently they developed over 6,000 new plays, and a lot of them one acts, but still, they produced Arthur Miller, Horton Foote, Wendy Wasserstein, Christopher Durang, David Mamet, Tennessee Williams, like those crappy plays he was writing towards the end of his life, and of course, the most famous thing that they do is
the one-act play fest?
Marathon that they have every year, when they still do. And Dempster won an Obie in 1974. That's an off-Broadway Village Voice Award. And Dempster was an actor. He appeared in a couple of shows and in the film Desperately Seeking Susan. I have to check that out to see what part he played in that. And he was a playwright, including the works Mimosa Pudica, which I can kind of guess what that's about, and In Defense of Leonard Peltier. Ooh, I don't know what that was, but Leonard Peltier.
That was my timer. I'm going to explode soon.
Leonard Peltier, he was very big on this thing, this American Indian who was arrested and badly treated by the government. I know this personally because I interned for a few weeks at EST about 15 years ago. So I briefly knew Curt. He seemed like an okay guy and believed very strongly in the kind of things he was doing. And I didn't stick around much, but it was a kind of interesting breeding ground. Gary Busey would wander in one day, and some other sort of famous actors would come for a little while, work on something, drop off a script. It was
kind of odd place. You and I were talking about the theater on, like, Thursday night.
Yeah. Oh, we were talking about EST.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, so, I'm always going to seem like, I'm not like
well, that was just, like, interesting.
So what? Yeah. No, but I want to wish him, you know, it's not like we got close or anything, and I didn't really, the place wasn't my vibe, but I do wish him a happy goodbye, and I hope EST continues, and because it was kind of stagnating, it has been, they try and do all these different festivals that they get, things for like a First Light, where they're trying to have playwrights write new plays about modern technology, and I don't think they've gotten a good play out of it yet. But they're trying. They're, and that's all you can really
ask. The Floating Light Bulb was a great play. That old technology.
Did they do that one?
No.
Oh, no, because they produced Woody Allen. He's in some of their one-act festivals. Mm-hmm. But anyway, we've got to finish out the show. So
say goodbye to Curt Dempster.
And say goodbye to Denny Doherty and Ron Carey and Art Buchwald. Gosh, what a week. And we will be back right after this with the closing moments of my birthday show on Dave's Gone By.
Yay!
Do you know how easy and inexpensive it is to advertise on Dave's Gone By? You don't? Well, hey, it's even easier to find out. You can run a 30 or 60 second ad or sponsor a show segment or the whole show. Just go to davesgoneby.org to see the rates. Or call 516-295-1511, 516-295-1511. Bring your message to my audience. Advertise on Dave's Gone By.
You have an audience?
Yeah, a very small but devoted one, as I find out when I get emails and phone calls. I mean, there are people listening. And I think that's really cool.
Hard to believe, David.
And that's one of those things that makes this worth doing and makes me happy on my birthday, that I'm out here putting out the effort to do a fun radio show.
He's proud.
Yeah. Let me tell some folks a couple of things. First of all, thank you to our sponsors, Hewlett-Minuteman Press, 1315 Broadway. They're the copy kings of Broadway. Performing Arts Insider Theater Magazine. Find out more at performingartsinsider.com. Jeff, you want to do the others?
I was going to say that's my Bible of Broadway.
Performing Arts Insider certainly is. And where do you learn about mortgages?
At mortgagesrock.com.
That's right. And Joyce, are you there?
Uh-huh.
What's
oh,
Jeff's company?
Oh, Joyce, I'm bored. We're sorry we didn't. Didn't you want to talk about the dead people, too?
No.
No, so Joyce, come on. What is Jeff's, you know Jeff's company. What does he do?
It's called Fancy Schnancy Balloons.
And what do we do?
And you take care of everyone's decorating needs.
And what's the phone?
Entertaining needs.
And the phone
Well, you know,
phone
people
number?
Have some weird decorating needs.
I don't know, Jeff. What's your phone number?
Yes, it's 516.
Uh-huh.
Come on, we only have all night.
797.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
3229.
797-3229. Seriously, folks, he does a great job. He does centerpieces for the tables. He does these big balloon
arches. With the bomb, it's the specialist.
Exactly. Everything but flowers. Jeff can decorate it and do it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's see. You've done that.
First, you have to thank your parents for birthing you.
For birthing me.
Well, your
thank
mother
my beloved...
had him.
What's right?
Your what? Mother had you.
Well, Dad was there briefly.
He had something to do with it.
Yeah. He provided the fluids. Mom baked the cake. I don't even know what that means.
But I do like that.
Thank you.
I think that's very good. Don't you, Joyce? You go bake any cakes, Joyce?
What?
Do you bake any cakes, Joyce?
No, I don't cook.
She's not a cake baker. She makes salads.
I'm not domestic, Jeff.
She's not a
she's
cake baker?
She's going to make me a cake salad tomorrow. That'll be exciting.
It will be the first salad you've had, David, in quite some time.
It's vegetables in that salad, David.
I know.
I give them a meat salad.
Well, I do put grapes in it, so there's a little bit of fruit. So.
Anyway. There's a little bit of fruit in everyone's table.
And you know what? I put nuts in my salad, too. So
everyone's a little bit nuts.
Nuggies. There, okay.
And fruity.
So, what did I want to say? Thank you also. I want to give a shout-out to a couple of people. Art Paul Schlosser wrote, I forgot to print it out, but he's got a new CD out. He seems to have a new one out every couple of weeks, so congrats to Art Paul. Go Googling for him.
We have a new CD singer. Out, too.
No, I do. Well, every week
we put out a new CD.
Which you can get for $11, ladies and gentlemen, shipping and handling.
But this week they're on sale for $9.99.
Okay, yes they are. $9.99, any Dave's Gone By compact disc. And they're run between an hour and 75 minutes long of pure entertainment.
Because
just
it's
like
pure
this.
Dave.
Well, yeah, until,
Dave, it's just
until
another
Jeff
word.
Became part of the show. And
Dave is just another word for entertainment.
The Dave is a world of entertainment. Anyway, let's see, who else do I want to... Well, no time for more shout-outs, but I do want
to... No, don't we have to thank the radio psychic, Joyce Keller, because she hasn't...
Thank you, yes.
She hasn't, and how about the guys who aren't doing the radio station up in the north?
Well, no, we don't have to at the moment, but Joyce Keller, listen to her every Wednesday night at 11 for her show, and then Swing City Vic on Sunday nights at 9 with an hour of swing music on WGBB.
And also, I think I'll be up for adoption on the adoption show.
Aww.
Why are you promoting them? They don't promote us.
Aww.
Well, if I'm going to be up for adoption.
Yeah.
Right? Isn't it like old kids up for adoption?
Yeah, that's exactly it. Yeah, if anybody wants to adopt Jeff. Yeah. Well, the phones just went completely... People were making phone calls elsewhere, and they hung up when they heard that.
He's so nice to me. Happy birthday, Dave.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. I want to remind people also, if you want to hear a vintage episode of Dave's Gone By, go to dfsxradio.com or to my website, davesgoneby.org, and you can listen on the web Thursday nights and Saturday nights at 11. You can also hear at Classic, remember our 100th episode? We've already passed 200, but our 100th episode happened, well, a few
in
months
December.
Ago. And you can
no,
hear
just
it
1 month ago.
At theaterpod.com.
Oh.
I'm going to, you know, Jeff, talk to people for a while. There's
oh,
another
we have
call.
Another
I'm
call.
See.
I think it's David's father.
I don't know.
Joyce, do you think it's David's
I'm
father?
I'm
going
to have to leave here for
I don't
know.
Well,
I pick
think
it
it's
up,
the
David.
Gospel people, Jeff. That's
no,
nice
they're here.
Know.
The gospel people are waving. They're very
oh.
nice.
Then maybe
and they, as a birthday gift, they gave David an extra half hour.
It could be Pam.
Is it Pam?
It could be Pam.
Who is this? Someone's calling and is going to come on the air. Isn't this exciting, Joyce? Did you
I was so excited I hit the button twice, so I lost him. But James Hodge, who's the gospel all night, James, please call back immediately at the radio station. Sorry about that.
Because a happy birthday now. Put the gospel show on.
Here, this is hopefully James. James, you're on the air.
Good morning. God bless you. How are you, Dave?
Thank you, James. Thanks
even
for
after he hung up on you?
Well, it was an accident.
Yeah, listen, it's not what others do to you, it's what you do to others. So
that's right.
And what I do to others would put me in prison. But, you know, thank you so much, man. I'm turning 43.
Let me say happy early birthday to you. I hope it's a prosperous year for you. And
oh,
I,
please, God. Yeah.
Not at GBB.
wherever it may be, you know, I thank God for both of you guys. And
we want it to be a happy and healthy birthday.
Please, God. Thank you. And thank you.
Healthy, prosperous, and, you know, I have to pray for everyone, you know.
Yeah, but since I'm part of everyone, I guess you can sneak in a little extra prayer for me. I need one.
Everyone's a little extra, because if you haven't noticed, it's his birthday today.
Yeah, I'm also desperate.
It's his birthday show today, and his birthday is on Tuesday.
Well, so I didn't want to miss this, I didn't want to miss this opportunity, and to say happy early birthday to you.
I appreciate
it. And I hope you have a good day, Dave.
Are you going to be on the air on Tuesday?
Not on Tuesday. I'll be on the air on Thursday night, but I have all the wonderful, wonderful hosts that will be there. Actually, Monday night, Tuesday morning, Ace will be. So I know she'll probably send a few birthday shout-outs to you. Praise God.
Yeah, Ace is here. She's waiting to get on the air as we speak, Ace, so she'll be on in about 5 minutes.
She is the Ace of Gospel.
Yeah, she is.
Ace is one of the best.
Love Ace.
She could have no other name to match her. She is Ace.
Huh.
Ace is the board and the program.
She is a lovely, lovely lady.
Yes.
Yeah, she really is. I'm not even going to make fun because she is so nice. And it's so nice of you, James, to call in and wish me a very, very happy, and I appreciate that. And I thank everybody at WGBB for their good wishes and for letting me do what I do here every week, and Jeff also for being part of that. I'm very grateful. I do want to remind people also that Jeff's generally going to be here for Dave's Gone By, although in February you're going away for a bit, so you'll be on one or two more episodes here,
yes.
And then I want to tell everybody about The Big Time, which is on a different radio station, WUSB, out in Stony Brook. We're there every other Friday from 3 until 6:30 in the morning, except we're going to miss the next cycle because of a reggae marathon.
Oh, really? We are going to miss it?
We are going to
miss
it.
It
won't be until the middle of February that there'll be a Big Time. Jeff will be gone, but anyway. So if you're waiting with
two more
days
gone by, and that's it.
Bid you a good night and a good morning to Ace. Again, happy birthday to you, Dave.
Thank you, ma'am.
To you, Jeff.
Thank you.
And continue to, do what you do, and we'll do what we do.
We keep a little laugh in everyone's heart.
Hopefully.
God bless you guys.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, James Hodge from the gospel programming on WGBB. Well, we're going to keep doing what we do as long as I can do it.
Thank you, Joyce.
And Joyce, love, you there?
I'm here. I wanted to tell James I loved it when his Nana was on. I thought that was the sweetest part of the New Year's special. It was a great show.
Yeah.
But when he interviewed Nana, he's so lucky to have, to have a grandma that's there. I wish my grandparents were there. Yours, too.
Yeah.
I thought it was so sweet.
Well, if my grandparents were here now, they would smell really bad.
No, but, I thought it was a beautiful... I thought it was one of the... When people called in, it was very nice on your New Year's Eve show, but that I thought was touching.
I love that, too, but there was only one point I liked better.
What was that?
That was the bathroom phone call from the...
Oh, we can't mention it.
Was that Joyce, the radio psychic, in the bathroom?
No. That was Bonnie D. Graham, who does a Friday night show, the Bonnie, was dating on
the Bonnie D. Graham bathroom. Is that a dating show from the bathroom?
They were near the bathroom. I don't think they were actually physically...
No, they were in the bathroom on New Year's Eve. She was in there. I guess the acoustics were...
We can call her Bathroom Bonnie.
Yeah. Oh,
she'd
love that.
This is a new nickname. So if you call her up on, when does her show, Friday night? Friday nights at 6. Say, Bonnie, bathroom. Yeah. Bathroom Bonnie.
I'm not doing that.
I will. I'll ask her about dating advice, because I guess you find all your best dates in the bathrooms. Because there was a man.
Maybe in your heyday. I don't know about everybody else, Jeff. Anyway.
Happy birthday, Dave.
Thank you.
Happy birthday, honey.
How about letting Ace get on the air and start her gospel
show? Can we sing happy birthday to you?
That
one
would
last
be lovely.
Time?
I don't think you have to pay.
I can only sing in Spanish, Jeff.
Okay, we'll do it in Spanish.
Feliz años a mí. Go ahead.
Felicidades a ti.
Happy birthday to you.
Feliz.
Okay, you do one line in Spanish. I'll do the next one in English.
Like Spanglish. Okay, here we
start?
Go.
Yes.
Felicidades a ti.
Happy birthday to you.
In tu dia feliz.
If I don't do... Wait, we'll try this again. Oh, God. Let's try it again.
Jeff, this is why we never were on Broadway, honey.
This is
why our show closed.
Wait, try it again.
Okay. Felicidades a ti.
Happy birthday to you.
In tu dia feliz.
Happy birthday, dear David.
Oh, now I can do it.
Felicidades a ti.
I feel like Simon Cowell.
I know.
I think we should be the new American Idol.
Yeah.
Oh, Jeff, I don't know, honey. We got to practice.
I-D-L-E, I think, is the spelling.
Happy birthday.
You've been listening to Dave's Gone By.
It's his birthday show.
But we will be back with a non-birthday show next week on Sunday Night Catch.
And then the following week, it's my Goodbye to Thailand show.
Oh. Something like, yeah. Well, not Goodbye to Thailand. Hello to Thailand. And goodbye to New York for a couple of weeks. Anyway.
Dave just hates getting off the air on his birthday show. Happy birthday, David.
I would love
David.
To be here all night, but there's someone waiting outside to start her program.
Let her go.
Nice
let her go.
Her
that's
in.
Not right.
The gospel people want to listen to your birthday show.
No, I'm sure they. Yeah, I'm sure they've had a lovely time listening. Now it's time to play their music and get this heathen Jew off the air.
Are you a heathen Jew?
Pretty much, yeah. I mean, I'll try to be, but, you know, I'm just me.
But you didn't tell us how nice you liked our version of Happy Birthday to You in English Spanish.
It was delightful. It was marvelous.
Can we go on the road now?
We can do it next week again if you want.
Ooh,
next week, same
Joyce?
Time, 11 o'clock to midnight on WGBB, AM 1240. Don't miss the pre-show at 10:30. I'm Dave Lefkowitz.
Happy Birthday, Dave Lefkowitz, from Jeff Goodman.
Good night.
And Gone By.
Monday, Monday, so good to me. Monday morning, it was all I hoped it would be. Oh, Monday morning, Monday morning, couldn't guarantee that Monday evening you would still be here with me. Monday, Monday, trust that day. Monday, Monday, sometimes it just turns out that way. Oh, Monday morning, you gave me no warning of what was to be. Oh, Monday, Monday, how could you leave and not take me? Every other day, every other day, every other day of the week is fine, yeah. But whenever Monday comes, you can find me crying all of the time. Monday, Monday, so good to me. Monday morning, it was all I hoped it would be. But Monday morning, Monday morning, couldn't guarantee
that Monday evening you would still be here with me.
Every other day, Monday, Monday, can't trust that day. Monday, Monday, it just turns out.